Why were the last 6 minutes of the video of last Friday's debate on the Appropriation Bill, which aired on the social media pages of the National Television Network, edited out? That portion of the video featured Castries Central MP Richard Frederick accusing the opposition leader Alan Chastney of misleading the House on the sale of lands at Latok and requesting the Speaker to have him provide evidence that there was corruption involved in the sale. The video of the House sitting was taken down minutes after the live video ended and re-uploaded hours after. Speaking to members of the media ahead of Tuesday's House sitting, the Information Minister Ernest Hilaire was questioned about the deleted portion. While he did admit that the video was purposely edited, he however denied it being done out of mischief.
There was some editing of the ending of the exchange that took place, which was really beyond the debate that took place. So the debate has not been deleted. There is every member's contribution, as far as I know, is available on NTN. Every member's contribution is there. So if they're talking about the exchange that took place after, we don't think it was necessary for it to be publicly broadcasted. It is available if anybody wants to see it. It is available, but in terms of the debate, it was not part of the substantial debate.
According to the minister, accusations were made which can be considered libelous and can expose the public broadcasting station to a lawsuit, something he said he has experienced himself.
You cannot call somebody, you know, a particular characterization, and the person says, look, this is defamatory and this is libelous. And for us to be propagating it and promoting it in the public domain, it had been said about me. And the whole of St. Lucia was made to be convinced I had stolen a vehicle. And NTN carried it over and over and over because they were running the show. They said I was selling diplomatic passports. Untrue. And so carried over and over by NTN. That's wrong. That's wrong.
Furthermore, says the Information Minister, the cutting out of portions of video of House sittings is not an unusual occurrence.
There was a contribution made by Dr. Kenny Anthony where he criticized a bill presented by the former Prime Minister which was deleted completely. And there was also the 30th anniversary of independence address made by the former Prime Minister that nobody can find on NTN, YouTube or Facebook because from what I was told it was a speech delivered elsewhere. I don't know that there was any malicious intent.
But under whose directive was the editing done? This was the minister's response.
I am saying to you, the station had to use discretion. I can't tell you A, B, C, D or anything like that. The station had to use direction. So either you think it was a wise decision or a wrong decision. I think it was a wise decision.
Opposition leader Alan Chastney, however, is not convinced of the Information Minister's defense arguments.
I did not know that he, as the Minister of Information, had the right to be a judge and jury. You cannot extract what are comments made in the House. In fact, we're protected in the House, the last time I was checked, in terms of whatever reason. Not that I would need that protection, but that is a lame excuse for a government that is more and more looking like a police state. When we look at the Suppression Act, when we look what they did when they first came with COVID to take away the state of emergency and impose restrictions on people's civil rights. And now, I mean, this is very clear, blatant manipulation of public information.
Meanwhile, the Information Minister has indicated that such action will be taken whenever deemed necessary.
Anytime any member says a statement against them is defamatory or libelous, we have a moral obligation not to carry it over and over, unless that person who said it has proven it to the House. And I maintain that across the board. I have suffered from it. I have lost opportunities overseas for work, my reputation, because they did it to me. I know the consequences of doing it to people over and over. They did it to me. I survive. I still hold my head up high because I know myself, but they did it. That's the nastiness of the politics. I will not support it being done to anybody, whether it's UWP, whether it's Labour.
For the DBS News World, I am Zid Romulus.